Hello, welcome everyone to this third episode of Explore series. Jagran Viscraft, MIME School of Entertainment and Events, focused under the Faculty of Journalism and Creative Studies, is spearheading this initiative, Explore series, that brings real-world lessons into the academic sphere to help prepare generations of future media, entertainment, events, and advertising industry leaders. I want to welcome Mr. Roshan Abbas. Roshan Abbas is, as you all know, one of the pioneers, one of the key leaders in the space that we are talking about today. And I think to have Roshan with me in the as the guest today in this third episode of Explore series is pretty daunting for me, because he's such a maverick in terms of the way that he conducts his stories, the way that he conducts his work, the way he thinks about it. It's a very well encompassed and a very long journey that he has undertaken, and to have him on this Explore series, is amazing. As I introduce Roshan to all of you, he's one of the finest orators and storytellers, as most of you would know. He has been a TV and radio host, film and theater director, author of the bestseller on public speaking sessions. Roshan founded and led Encompass, now Geometry Encompass, as managing director, into becoming amongst India's four largest, most awarded experiential marketing agency. He was also an initial investor in and continues to be a mentor partner at The Glitch. Both ventures have been acquired by WPP. Roshan has won several national level awards for TV and radio. In 2015, he co-founded Commune, a performing arts collective for storytellers. He has also helped conceptualize Spoken Festival, bringing together performers from across the world for storytelling, poetry, and spoken word and song. It's an honor to have you, Roshan, with us today in this Explore series, the third episode. And as I start this particular session, I just want to hear it from you first. Your journey, the way you look at storytelling, the way you look at experiences which are framed as part of the stories, and many things which you have, shared with so many people in the past. Everybody out there would want to hear from you first. Roshan, please tell us something about that.
Thank you so much. Can you hear me? I hope I'm audible to you. Yeah.
Yes, you are. Yes.
Yeah. I mean, I mean, when people say, am I audible? I often turn and say, no, I'm Spotify. Because that's one of the latest places that I've been on. So thank you so much for everybody who's joining in, and people who are watching this wherever you all are. My journey actually is possibly the journey of all of you students who are there right now, across Jagran Lake University, across Viscraft MIME, across any institute you might be at. Because the important thing that I want to tell you is that all journeys, I think, are creative journeys, so very often start with curiosity. And fueling and fulfilling your curiosity is what makes you a creator. I was curious by nature since I was very, very young. I was in Lucknow, small city. And I mean, Lucknow in the 70s is not the way small cities are today. I mean, I can tell you that there was extremely conservative. What you all often hear, ke, you know, padhoge, likhoge, nawab, kheloge, kudoge, hoge, kharab. Wo baat tab bhi bahut mashhoor thi. And, there were only a couple of professions. You could be a doctor, you could be an engineer, you could join the armed forces. That was the third option in Lucknow, because many people used to join the armed forces from my school. IAS ki bhi baat nahi shuru hui thi. People wouldn't even talk about that. Or, so this was the only options you had. And I was a good student. Actually, frankly, a very, very good student. I was amongst the top two students in my class always. But somewhere along the line, my parents always gave me, our school used to be from 8 to 1. But from 1 p.m. onwards, there used to be extracurricular. So half the time, I remember having cold lunches in school, but then having the most warm afternoons because of the things I was doing. I was part of elocution, debating, dramatics, quizzing, Just a Minute, festivals, singing, you name it. I would try my hand at most everything. And when I would do these things, it would almost always be an exploration, a curiosity that carried me there. Our school had a lovely tradition of giving us books. when you won a prize at Prize Day. So my big thing was that I used to look on my entire annual library to come from the school Prize Day. So I would win 5 to 7 prizes and then we'd be sent to Universal Booksellers where we could choose a book. And choosing a book, I must tell you, was such a joy because, you know, you could almost go, every book is a trapdoor that leads you to another world, right? It's the door that leads you, it's a portal to another world. And as a young child, I read what many people tell me when they tell me what they're reading in college. I don't snigger, but I have a little bit of a intellectual snigger in my mind saying, "Main toh school mein padha tha," because you know that was our escape route. There was nothing else. I mean, you would know that hamare liye wohi kuch cheeze thi. We used to listen to audio cassettes. I remember Amin Sayani's voice and Mukaddar Ka Sikandar dialogues and. You know, you're being told a story by Amin Sayani and then after that you hear one dialogue in Bachchan Saab's voice and you hear two lines of a song. That was Netflix for us, by the way. You must understand. Yeah. On regular radio, there were 3 shows. Modi Ke Matwale Rahi, Inspector Eagle and Hawa Mahal. Mujhe ye 3 show yaad hai. See, look at how you're laughing because we are both the same vintage, right? And यहाँ पर किसी बच्चे को पता तक नहीं होगा हम किस चीज के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं बट जैसे आप लोग टिकटॉक के बारे में बात करते हैं हमको पता नहीं होता उस तरीके से हम जो बात कर रहे हैं आपको पता नहीं होगा बिकॉज हमारे जमाने के मीडियम्स ये थे वी हैड लॉट्स मोर टाइम एंड व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस इज बिकॉज देयर वाज अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ दिस क्यूरियोसिटी टू लर्न दिस हंगर टू रीड दिस हंगर टू लिव इन डिफरेंट वर्ल्ड्स वाज द हंगर दैट एक्चुअली टुक मी फ्रॉम लखनऊ टू दिल्ली. I was a very good student. I was doing biology. I wanted to be a doctor. And then one day I discovered dramatics and I loved the stage. And I went to my parents and I told them, can I go to Delhi? And they allowed me. They gave me a limited timeline and they gave me limited money, which is also very good. Unlimited resources of anything are wrong. Because, you know, agar koi deadline nahi hogi, agar koi ticking time bomb nahi hota life mein, toh kuch nahi hota. And I had this ticking time bomb in my head saying, I've got 3 years of college. If I do well in college, then I will be allowed to do my master's in Delhi. Otherwise, my parents might call me back. Not that they were going to. So I did my bachelor's in English. But while I was at Hindu college, again, the principal understood this intellectual curiosity and this creative curiosity and let me do what I wanted. I mean, many of you now will be reading about the fact how athletes in the US, it only happened just 2 days back, have been given permission that, oh my God, if a university is using its athletes to earn money and fame, it should be shared with students. It's a breakthrough thing. But in my school, the same thing was happening in my college that my principal called me in the end of first year and said, Roshan, tum hame bas 3 bade debates jita diya karo. Saal ke. You know, those reputed debates, do what you want. So I frankly must tell you that in college, I attended very few classes which were theory, but my life ke practical classes attend kara tha. I attended more festivals than anyone could have. I was at every college festival. Ramjas, Kirodi Mal, Bits Pilani, Oasis, aap naam lije wahan par hota. And I would do everything. I would take part in everything I could. Mono acting, dramatics, debating, you know, street play, music, jo tha. Because that creative exploration, which your generation today is able to do because of access to the internet and the democratization of the media, hame khojna padta. Straight after this, I went into mass communication. And again, I'm telling you of this journey because you all are at a university. And very often nowadays, you know, you'll see some young YouTuber who's 15. There's a boy who's 9 years old who makes some 50 million. And you must be saying, what the hell am I doing? But will he make it forever? I don't know. Will he, after a couple of years, be just leading a vacuous life? I don't know. I don't wish him that. But, you know, if you fill your life with these kind of learnings, all your life, you've got things to do. And when I was doing professional theater in college with Amir Raza Hussain and I met some of the best people in my life that I know today. The more you are part of creative endeavors while you are at Jagran Lake University and Viscount Mine, explore the other aspects, do your own little podcast, do your own little creative writing, do what you can, because these are the ways you can explore the world as well. And I would also highly recommend that some of them are physical and not virtual. Varna to your world matrix ban jayega, ki everybody's just plugged into a machine. Which you don't want, you know. And from here, when I came out from MassCom, I must tell you, there were no careers in media. There was nothing. There were jobs at 5,000 rupees, 5,500 rupees available in TV18, which is now Viacom 18. So I'm talking 30 years back almost. Yeah. And at that point in time, I was a great editor. I was offered a job as an editor. And I didn't want to edit because I had a 10,000 rupee monthly bill. अरे कैसे करूंगा कैसे करूंगा. तो आई डिड मल्टीपल जॉब्स. आई वुड राइट अ वॉइस ओवर समवेयर, राइट अ स्क्रिप्ट, डू अ वॉइस ओवर, एंकर अ शो, ट्राई माय हैंड्स एट मल्टीपल थिंग्स. एंड वन डे आई हर्ड अ पर्सन ऑन रेडियो हु आई डिडंट रियली लाइक. नाउ दिस इज अनदर प्रॉब्लम. इफ यू डोंट लाइक थिंग्स टुडे, आर्मचेयर एक्टिविज्म इज वेरी वेरी इजी. आप एक ट्वीट डाल दीजिए, आप एक इंस्टाग्राम पे डिसलाइक कर दीजिए, आप किसी को जो है वो कैंसिल कर दीजिए. बट आर यू टेकिंग एनी रियल एक्शन? I could have, if there was social media, I could have written a tweet saying hashtag, you know, host sucks. But that would not have made a difference. I took my bike the next morning, went to All India Radio, found a way to get into All India Radio, met the assistant station director and said, sir, I love FM as a medium. I don't like your anchors. And the guy said, what will you do about it? Hmm. And I said, I'll do something about it. And I went and anchored a show. This was Friday. I was anchoring a show on Sunday. So, you know, I had to think on my feet. I had to come up with unique ideas. I did all of that. And this is my journey in terms of my educational journey. From here on, my educational journey became a PhD in life. Because life gives you lessons which you can also keep learning. And many people, I believe, don't listen to life enough. So what I did was that I was being called. I was an anchor. I was hosting three shows on radio. I was hosting three shows on television. And I believe you me, in that time and age, if one was hosting just one of any of these shows and not six of them, it was more than enough. But but because I had the opportunity to do so many of these, I somehow just managed to get more and more opportunities to just share with you know, my talent with the world. And I kept using those. मुझे अभी भी याद है, यू नो दिवाकर, दैट आई होप आई कैन कॉल यू दिवाकर एंड नॉट
प्रोफेसर
शुक्ला, यू नो. सो जी,
नो नो, ऑफ कोर्स, बिकॉज़ आई आल्सो शेयर द सेम सिटी विद यू रोशन, नखलाऊ.
हां नखलाऊ, हां नखलाऊ, हमारा नखलाऊ, या जिसको बहुत लोग एक बार डिवाइड करके लखनऊ कहते थे कि लक मिलेगा नाउ, यू नो. तो यू नो व्हाट हैपेंड वाज दिवाकर, दैट आई एक्चुअली many people would tell me, why are you trying to set up something, enjoy karo, badi gaadi, bada ghar, wo le lo. And I said, nahi yaar, agar bade sapne hai na, to pehle unko fund karna chahiye. I was an anchor. I would do events, but many event companies, as I said 2 days ago also to my dear friend Gokul, that event companies were well-meaning, not well-planned, not well-trained. And see, 95-97 mein, event industry bahut early thi. Viscraft was one of the rare companies that actually had existed, but it was in Bombay. I remember in those days, Viraf would come to Delhi and I would travel with him sometimes in train to places like Ludhiana and Jalandhar, and I would go to 32nd Milestone and anchor events for them. But, you know, there were many other Delhi event agencies that were very jugadu, and matlab unke show jo the, wo kehte the Bhagwan chalata. तो क्या होता है कि आपने एक आइडिया बना दिया लेकिन आपने प्लानिंग नहीं करी है, व्हाटएवर. सो आई वुड एंड अप गोइंग एंड एक्चुअली गेट ऑन स्टेज एंड इन माय माइंड द थिएटर मी वुड बी वर्किंग एंड द थिएटर मी वुड से हाउ कैन आई मेक दिस बेटर, हाउ कैन आई मेक इट मोर एक्साइटिंग, व्हाट कैन आई डू एटसेट्रा. एंड आफ्टर डूइंग दिस अ कपल ऑफ टाइम्स एंड सेविंग मेनी शोज बाय जस्ट टॉकिंग, आई मस्ट टेल यू, देयर वाज अ फैशन शो आई वाज डूइंग एट बसंत कॉन्टिनेंटल होटल, वेयर The only thing the event person had done was saying, sir, मैं stage swimming pool पे बना रहा हूँ. तो I said, ठीक है, पर उससे क्या होगा? नहीं सर, कभी नहीं हुआ लाइफ में. I said, okay, very good. But in making that stage of the swimming pool, he hadn't planned on certain things, so the show got delayed by 2 hours. Then he didn't have enough money to pay the models. And I remember, you know, my, you know, I mean, so many of these memories are so, you know, Milind Soman, etc. in those days was so famous. And all of these people were backstage and they were like refusing to come on stage because they weren't being paid. And they were like, pata nahi Delhi mein paise milenge ki nahi milenge. And I had to stay on stage for 2 hours till the man arranged money for them to pay them before they could get on stage. And I kept anchoring. And that day I went home and I said, listen, ye na sara pressure mujh pe aa jata hai of doing a show. Why don't I instead put up a company? And I set up a company, you know, which was comprising of not people who had great CVs, because most people didn't have CVs in event management. But they had great experience. So somebody was from theater, somebody was from dance, somebody was from audiovisual, somebody was from lighting. And I got all these people together and set up Encompass at that point in time. So that was my first big foray. And when I set up Encompass, I really wanted, I was again blessed that one of my very dear friends at that time was Mr. Sandeep Goyal. Sandeep was the head of, Rediffusion DYNR. I don't know how many of you know of the agency. Sandeep was a person who used to very often take me for multiple, events. He would take me along with him for events and for pitches. And I learned how to pitch things really well through Sandeep Goyal. And Sandeep, really taught me that. And I structured Encompass like the way an advertising agency is structured. And this actually brings us to the point that you and I were discussing the other day about, through the line, above the line, below the line. So people used to always say that above the line is media that is seen by multiple people. And below the line is stuff that is normally not mass media. So it's not one to many, it's one to one. And in my head, I would say that any great piece of communication is actually one to one. Because if you make a great ad, it appeals emotionally to you as one, not you as a group. It's always you. So we came up with this thought of saying, let's do things that are through the line, not above the line or below the line. So one of our first challenges, I remember, and we would have loved to do these beautiful events in 5-star hotels. We were doing a Motorola conference in 97. We did the conference. It went off fabulously. And then the head of Motorola called me 3 months later. And this was, by the way, in 97, the launch of pagers, which again, your generation doesn't even know what they are. Pagers were mobile phones with no function except the screen and your keypad working. No calling, no nothing. And they said, they're not selling. What do we do? So we had to come up with a solution that said, maybe you want to sell these as devices that have location. Right, a pager had a GPS signal as well. So he said, to a person who doesn't have a address, usko ek address mil jayegi ek pager ke through. So we approached carpenters, painters, people who used to be daily job earners, and said, aap har subah market mein aapko wait karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Aap agar ek pager le lenge, to aapki ek apni identity ho jayegi, aapka ek apna ghar ho jayega, ek number ho jayega where people can call you. Now, how do you sell this? To sell this, we didn't have to do an event. We had to do a street play. The first day we did the street play in Nehru Place in Delhi, nobody came down. I said, itna acha play banaya, koi nahi aa raha hai. And that's when I learned that you need to do things that attract your audience to you. Right. So day one, we failed. I went back to the client. I said, give us tomorrow. We'll sort it out. And the client had faith. So the second day, we took dhol walas and we went at times when people would leave their office, morning before they went in, lunchtime or chai ka time.
Right.
And we had these dhol walas, so jahan pe dhol bajta tha, Hindustan mein log aise aa jate hain ki tamasha hone wala hai. And there we did a street play. And the other thing that we did was, imagine in 97, without any knowledge, finding the number of T-Series, HMV, Venus and all these companies and calling them and saying, humko teen audio cassettes banani. They said, why do you want an audio cassette? And I said, for people of that category, carpenters, laborers, etc., masons, they still used to have a 2-in-1 deck.
Correct.
So we said, we will, for anybody who buys a pager, we will give them a set of 3 cassettes called Dil, Dhadkan, or Dhamal. Yeah. And we took, Dhamal was filled with these Raja Babu kind of songs. And Dhadkan was all love songs. So we did those kind of categories. So we were a through-the-line agency. We were not an event company. And I'm saying this only because the world of events is not stuck at what you do inside a hall or inside an auditorium or inside a stadium. Today, you will realize that you need to do transmedia storytelling. You need to tell something that happens in digital, comes to physical, goes to YouTube, passes on to Spotify, is somewhere connected on TikTok, has a call to action which leads you to Amazon. This is a consumer journey. Or if as an event person, you don't understand this, you are limiting yourself to just one small thing. So don't get stuck in small things. Think bigger things. And while we continued to do this, this is what differentiated Encompass as an agency, made us not just a event agency, but an experiential agency. We we once upon a time, I remember when we, after Encompass events, we wanted to say, we don't want to be called events. So we called ourselves Encompass ESP. And people said, what is ESP? I said, kuch logon ka USP hota hai, hamara ESP hota hai. And they said, what does ESP mean? I said, well, unique selling point, ESP is your experiential selling point.
Oh, wow.
So, you know, we came up with that thought and whatever. It paid rich dividends because advertising agencies used to see us very often in marketing offices. And they realized that this is an agency that is thinking differently, that is thinking new. And in 2007, we started getting approached by a whole bunch of people, various brands, various clients. And when I say brands, I'm talking of advertising agencies. So JWT, Omnicom, there were 2-3 global syndicates. They all reached out saying, we want to partner with you or we want to buy equity in you. And me and my partner Sukrit at that time hadn't even thought of what this means. You know, what does it mean in 2007 or 8 to sell your equity? And I was like, I don't want to sell. They said, nee, nee, ye nahi that you're selling yourself out, you'll get money. I said, money, oh, great. But what will money do? Because I was making enough money as an anchor. But Sukrit put it very nicely for me. He said, you know, we need to be sitting on the same side of the table as an advertising agency, not on the other side.
Right.
We need to be compatriots. We don't need to be competition. I said, okay, that's a fair point. So we started speaking, and Colvin Harris, the head of JWT at that time, very dear friend of mine, he just loved what we were doing. Michael Meadle was the Asia head. Very quickly, in about 6-8 months, we had a deal on the table. And 2008, Encompass was sold. Majority stake was sold to WPP. And we were aligned with JWT. And 2009, we had the meltdown.
Right.
And when the meltdown happened, we learned two unique things, which was that most event companies, know, very often they say they live on a wing and a prayer. And even we did. I will not lie. We had event walon se baat kijiye, unko lagta sab acha hi hoga. You know, kal event hai, ho jayega, you know, permission mil jayegi, artist aa jayega, aa jayega. But, you know, we suddenly realize you're being asked by our regional head saying, what's your prediction for next quarter and your prediction for the next quarter? And financial jurisprudence came to us because of this WPP alliance. And suddenly we were making predictions and we had 7 offices. We closed 4 of them saying, no, these are more servicing teams, not business getting teams. We took those people. We are always known for our culture and our people policies. We gave all of those people preferred vendor partner status with us. And we said, if we do any work in Chennai or in Hyderabad or in Calcutta, you guys will be the first people who will have the first right of refusal. And out of the 4 offices, Devakar, at least 3 of those people became entrepreneurs and set up their own agencies. And we limited ourselves to Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore, and we continued with the work we were doing. And suddenly we were thrown into the deep end of the pool when Airtel called us and said that we had managed Formula One in year one. Somehow we'd managed to get into the sport. Sukrit loved any sport. And so he was very gung-ho about doing sports events. I am not a sports person at all. I mean, I will watch the highlights of a cricket match, you know. So what happened was that my partner Sukrit said, no, we must do Formula One. And he'd got to meet up with the JP people who ran the Buddha International Circuit. And he said, you know, you've got to come and witness F1. And we came in the first year. I mean, it was a lot of fast cars going around and everything was fast. We watched it and everything happened in the blink of an eye and came back. And, you know, year one, while Airtel was the title sponsor, they didn't get enough mileage because Vodafone ambushed the event. And they very smartly put up a campaign which had, you know, their car and their driver and everything else. And Airtel felt very bad because they were like, you know, humne sare sponsorship ke paise diye, hame utna naam nahi mila. And at that point in time, Bharat Bambawale, who was the head of advertising, I mean, he was the head of marketing at Airtel. He called Sukrit and me. And he said that you guys have to do the entire campaign for Formula One. And I was like, what do you mean? And he says, no, from the ad to the Facebook page, to the on-ground event, to our hoardings. And we were up for a challenge. But again, imagine this is 2010. Right. We are still a very young agency. We have never done this kind of work before. And I just turned to Bharat and I said, Bharat, why are you giving us this work? And he said, you know, why is all communication coming from some people in an advertising agency who then will come up with an idea without knowing the audience of the spot?
Right.
Right. And they will come up with a big idea, then they will give it to somebody who will give it to somebody. And by the time it comes to you, there'll be nothing left. He said, why don't we reverse it? If you know the audience of the sport, if you know the people who really understand Formula One, you guys have to get the fans to the event. And ultimately, for me, success is that 100,000 people are watching Formula One live and millions are watching it online. Who else but you guys to do it? And we were so inspired that we said, give us a week and we'll come back with a strategy. And again, we could have just been an event company and said, hum aapki race chala denge aur opening ceremony pe char log gaane ga denge, you know. But we turned and said, no, we will do more. And we came up with the idea that Airtel will buy sponsorship on one of the vehicles, which was a Mercedes vehicle. And they said, but why do you want us to buy sponsorship? We are already sponsors of the race. We said, no. Just like Sachin Tendulkar is the only man known with cricket in that year.
Right.
Michael Schumacher is the only person known with Formula One.
Right.
And by sponsoring just the India leg of the Mercedes, you know, Formula One team, you got one day of shoot and one day of time with Michael Schumacher and, you know, Nicky, who was his co-driver.
Right.
And they were like, really? And we said, yeah. And we suddenly got Aggie, my friend from Taproot, involved. And we said, Aggie, write a great commercial. Aggie came up with a fabulous line. And in 1 week's time, Diwakar, we were traveling to negotiate with Michael Schumacher.
Wow.
And next week, we were shooting an ad with him. And I want to show you guys that in 2010, this is what we created. So if you don't mind, I'll share my screen. Yeah. And
yes.
Yeah, just, yeah. Okay. So, sure. So. Yeah. Can you see my screen?
Yes, we can. Yeah.
Great. So. Now, making this commercial, nobody believed that you could. There was no sound. I'm my apologies. I think there was some. my apologies. So you guys didn't get to see what I got to see, but I was happily hearing it. But I think somebody will need to just. I'm just trying to see that. When I'm sharing, somehow the sound is...
So when you're sharing the screen, Roshan, you can... When you're sharing the screen, there's a small tick on the lower...
I know. Normally it comes, I don't know, optimize for video clip and share sound. You're right. Sorry. Okay, guys, round two. So okay. at events, this is normally what you do as a rehearsal. So this was a rehearsal. Okay. My apologies. My sincere apologies to you all. I will... try and share. Just give me 1 second because I think it's gone to another commercial and I don't want to show you. Can you hear the sound now?
No, Roshan. You can't hear the sound.
Achha. So, kuch garbad hai, but let me fix this, guys. So don't worry. We are event people. We normally manage to do these things. Okay. Uh Got it. I also realize what the other problem is.
Yeah, can you hear me now?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay, great. Huh. So the first problem was that I was using my headphones as an input.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Well, issue one. At some events, we realize our problems late. Then again, my apologies for that. But let's hope we get it right this time. Can you hear now?
Yeah, yeah, we can.
Great, great. Okay, so ab aa raha hai. Now you see it in full glory.
Yeah, yeah.
And you won't believe, in terms of share of voice, Divakar, we got so much more, in terms of just the reactions, the crowd. And Mr. Mittal couldn't believe. He was like, how did you all manage all this? And we were like, sir, as event managers, we do, when everybody else looks right, we look left. True. People will say, aise hona hai, hum 100 tarike dhoond lete hain. So the joy of being an event manager is that you're able to think of very different solutions and never lose that as a quality. This was a 30 crore campaign.
Wow.
Right? I mean, and that is time when people's annual billings used to be 7 to 10 crores. Right? So, I mean, doing something like this was so big that it was, I remember, a landmark moment for us. And I was on the Cannes jury before this. After that, many other Indian people actually also went. But it was just, it established us. For many people is saying, oh, these are not just event managers. These are people who do more. And this thirst to do more is actually what carried me on in my journey. I actually took a 2-year break to make a film, which was another story altogether. I did all of that because I think I wanted to creatively satisfy that urge. And from there, I went into a completely different space where at the end of the film, I invested in a digital agency. And I invested in a company called The Glitch. And The Glitch has become amongst India's top digital agencies today. They're a digital first creator agency. And they used to do a strange mix of digital first experiences, which to me were the next level of events. And when nobody believed in them in 2011, I remember I went to JWT and I said, invest in these people now. And they were like, Nani, they're too small. They were sub 1 crore. And I was like, if you don't invest, I'll invest. And in my life, it's been my best investments. People, I invest in a lot of startups, but this was one investment which has given me humongous return purely because, you know, you'll always find people who do something different, which you really admire. And those are the people to invest. So going along this route, in 2015, Sukrit, my partner, turned and said that, listen, we have to have a larger piece of the pie. And we should be doing rural marketing and shopper marketing and not just events, not just activations. And I'm like, but how will we do this? And there was a company called Ogilvy One, which you would know really well. You know, so Ogilvy One had been rechristened Geometry.
Right.
And Geometry was a group that handled brands like Lifebuoy, handled a bit of Unilever work, handled some Mondelez work. And we went and merged these two agencies because we said that if you really want to be the event and experiential agency of the future, you have to be able to provide a brand touch points at every point in the consumer journey. If the person gets up in the morning, aapko radio ad banana chahiye. Agar wo aadmi akhbar padhta hai, to newspaper mein insert dalna aana chahiye. Agar wo road par jata hai, to usko hoarding par kuch karna, you should know. If he is going to a mall, will you do an activation? If he goes to an event, you know, like, and that's right. The thinking you need. You know, and many event companies get stuck by just thinking about one thing. But we always thought this entire 360 degree through the line approach. And as we continued doing this, our aspiration internally was, I wish the team gets to do more work. And one day in a workshop with the Brooke Bond, there was a conversation where the Brooke Bond team said that, you know, Brooke Bond brings people together. Red Label brings people together.
Right.
And how can we bring people together? Chalo, hum log ek chai ka utsav karte hain, ye karte hain, wo karte hain, whatever. You know, our prime minister already done chai pe charcha and whatever. So I was like, the team, our creative director turned and said that, you know, tea also brings people who are very different together. And this is a unique thing that happens. And this brings me actually to your topic here about honesty versus virality, right? Because the whole thing was that, you know, is virality about something, you know, a new dance step that becomes popular or whatever, etc. Honesty can be most viral as long as it touches people's hearts.
Right.
And one of the most honest truths that we had was that a research showed us, you know, a very interesting fact that many of the deities we worship, the idols we worship, are made by people of different religions.
Absolutely.
आप कभी ये नहीं सोचते हैं कि आप जिस यू नो आइडल को नतमस्तक हो रहे हैं उसको बनाया किसने. एंड सो वी एक्चुअली मेड अ कमर्शियल. एंड अगेन द फैक्ट वॉज दैट एन एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंसी वुड हैव टेकन 4 weeks, एन एंटायर प्री प्रोडक्शन प्लान, 1 crore बजट. वी टर्न्ड एंड सेड ये हमें बनाना है. एंड दैट इज द स्पिरिट ऑफ द इवेंट मैनेजर. हमको करना है, वी हैव टू डू दिस. एंड we want to do this because this is an honest piece of communication. And this is what we made 3 years ago. Again, became extremely popular in the entire advertising fraternity. So I'm going to show this to you now.
भैया, वो बप्पा की मूर्ति लेनी थी घर के लिए.
हाँ हाँ बिल्कुल, आता हूँ.
भैया वो पहली बार बप्पा को घर पे बिठाना है, तो कुछ स्पेशल बताइए ना.
आइए, ये देखिए,
चार भुजा वाली मूर्ति.
जी, इसे अभय मुद्रा कहते हैं.
अच्छा.
अरे छोटू, चाय चलेगी?
बिल्कुल.
देखिए
भैया, वो कोई बप्पा की मूषक के साथ वाली.
हाँ हाँ है ना, आगे आइए.
हाँ, इस मूर्ति में है ना बप्पा अपने वाहन के साथ.
मुशक, आप जानते हैं, मुशक बापा का वाहन बनने से पहले एक असुर था.
आपको तो काफी कुछ पता है. ये वाली
फाइनल कर दे.
एक्चुअली आज थोड़ा कुछ काम है, मैं कल आता हूँ.
भाईजान, चाय तो लेते जाइए. नमाज अदा करने वाले हाथ बाप्पा की मूर्ति सजाएंगे तो हैरानी तो होगी ही.
यही काम क्यों?
भाईजान, ये भी तो इबादत है. तो कल मिलेंगे ना?
नहीं, आप बप्पा की मूर्ति बुक कर दीजिए.
कौन सी? वो चार हाथ वाली?
नहीं नहीं, अभय मुद्रा वाली.
Brilliant. Wow.
Thank you. Thank you. So here, you know, Divakar, this is where we bring in the honesty of communication, the honesty of giving a message. And, you know, it took a lot of courage from the brand to do this. A couple of things that we have done. Sometimes brands are like, you know, always wondering whether we'll be able to deliver, they are scared, all of this happens. But if you want virality, go for honesty is what I always say. Aap trend bana sakte hain, lekin this generation today is really looking for more honest communication, communication that really connects. And many things in the event business are also becoming slowly about creating communication that doesn't need to be, you could, this is a full-fledged commercial, but what I'm going to show you guys next is something that just won a bronze for us at Cannes. It's called Hack Washing. And it's not an ad, it's an activation. It's an activation that touches thousands of people. It's an activation where first you say, why does soap need to be in the form of a soap? Can soap not be an ink? And suddenly we created an ink of soap by which you could give a tattoo to people's hands and they had to wash it. And if they washed it, their hands were getting cleaned. So that's where the idea came from. And a great idea can come from anywhere. You need to just bring it together. And, you know, when we were thanking people after winning the Cannes, my creative director turned and said, I don't just want to think of thank the people who thought of the idea or made the ink. What about the people who at 3 degrees in Kumbh were shooting it? What about the people who were distributing the sample? So it takes many, many people to create something absolutely unique. And this is, again, the future. This is honesty at a different level. This is the honesty of acknowledging that you can't do everything alone. Many people want to take all the credit. They want to, you know, sab hum karte hain. They will cut your name out. But today's generation will not rest for this. Today's generation wants their due, wants their name, wants their share of things. And that's what I hope people realize and are able to deliver. So I'm going to quickly share this with you all as one of the things that we did, which, again, I'm extremely proud of. And I feel that we have been able to create something unique with.
India is a country of 1.3 billion people, but over 60% of Indians don't use soap to wash their hands. With hands being essential to our culture, from eating to devotion, this deeply ingrained social behavior spreads fatal diseases. So during the world's largest human gathering, Kumbh Mela, a religious festival so massive, it creates the perfect conditions for mass-scale infections. We couldn't just change 150 million people's poor hand-washing habits overnight. We needed to hack them. Hack Washing by Lifebuoy. A wearable ink made of Lifebuoy formula, which turns into antibacterial soap when in contact with water. So simply by stamping people's hands at the festival, we made sure they also use a germ-killing soap every time they rinse their hands with just water. A low-budget, instant re-education campaign, teaching over 150 million people to use soap with no discarded samples and no waste.
क्योंकि सोच के बाद साबुन से हाथ न धोने की वजह से फैल सकती है डायरिया और निमोनिया जैसे घातक बीमारियां। इसीलिए
And the organizers' invitation to help in all future events, along with encouraging a real-time behavior change that reflected itself even in sales. A simple social hacking solution that not only insulated the world's largest human gathering from infections, but also made hand washing with just water safe for the first time ever in India. Hack Washing by Lifebuoy.
Wow.
So see, again, the whole thought is that honesty of sitting together with your team and saying everyone in the room can have an idea. I think some of my favorite clients are those who are honest enough to say, boss, you know this better than us. You know, gone are the old days where people used to do a lot of these things in their own manner. And I think these are things that are now changing a lot. People are changing. People are getting new ideas. You know, Encompass has grown. Encompass has changed formats. Encompass has changed names. And all of these things, I think, have somewhere just led to us creating a through-the-line agency that believes in finding virality where a brand's purpose and a customer's values come together. that's what we have done, you know.
Very true.
I thought we'll take a quick check if anybody has any questions or whatever, and then I could get into the last
there was one question in fact which popped up, and it was in line with what you just said in terms of what becomes viral is anything which is honest and honestly done definitely has a great potential to become viral. But the question is, how can content become viral across the media? And I think some bit of it you already kind of shared with us. But if you just want to take this question again, in a way, how can the content become
viral? So see, any content must have somewhere a target audience. Who is the target audience you're reaching for? Frankly, I always tell people that the day content moves from traditional media to WhatsApp is the day it becomes viral. The day people start sharing it spontaneously, it becomes viral. देखिए पैसे देके आप किसी चीज को वायरल कर सकते हैं. You can put $1 million behind an ad and inorganically make it really big. But that's not how you need to do it. You need to find what are people thinking about. Simon Sinek, of course, many people will tell you to listen, but you should listen to Simon Sinek, because what Simon Sinek has said is ask why. Right? The difference between Apple and many other brands is that Apple first answers the why. It's not what is they make computers, but why do they make computers? Because they make computers so that the square pegs in the round holes, the creative class who feels left out feels somebody takes care of me, right? That is their push always. And that's what's happening. More and more authentic brands are being created. If you want content to be viral, firstly, this is a philosophy which is very different to what many people say, because this is what happens. Advertising craft says make one idea and spend crores behind it. My philosophy is very different, where I say take 10 ideas and put small ships out there. Unme se 10 mein se 5 to doobi jayenge, 3 ko chota moti success milegi, 2 will become big. Unpe spend kijiye, unko aur bada kijiye, you know. It's just important. Or have somebody who understands consumers and consumer insights and understands. Piyush, who you know, Divakar, I know so well. What is Piyush? Piyush is a walking, talking dictionary almanac of Indian insights.
Right.
Which he picks up because he honestly listens and honestly conveys.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ye Hindustan hai. Hindustan mein ek truck mein 500 log travel karte hain gaon mein. क्या वो फेविकॉल की कहानी हो सकती है, राइट? सो आई थिंक दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, एंड आई थिंक समवेयर इफ यू वांट ऑनेस्ट कम्युनिकेशन, इफ यू वांट वायरलिटी, एम्पावर योर पीपल. द बिग प्रॉब्लम इज दैट वी रिवॉर्ड सक्सेस एंड वी पनिश फेलियर. यू हैव टू ऑल्सो लर्न हाउ टू रिवॉर्ड फेलियर एंड से यू ट्राइड. अनफॉर्चुनेटली ब्रांड्स डोंट पे यू फॉर फेलियर. But I'll tell you, good brands, I've worked with some great brands who said, koshish kari thi. I worked with Colgate Palmolive, I remember, on a couple of projects. It didn't work. The marketing director said, it's okay, we tried. This doesn't happen because unfortunately, very often, marketing people are trying to ladder their success on the back of your idea. So they're so concerned about success. But how can everything in the world be successful? How can, and I again feel that experimentation happens a lot more if you're okay with failure. Did Einstein get E is equal to MC squared the first time? No. He must have made 1,000 wrong formulas. Elon Musk, how many of those rockets have landed and fallen in the water? Did he give up? No. So this honesty of saying, karo, try karo. I keep saying that people must keep trying. I mean, and that's frankly where I built Commune, which is my next story that I will come to. But, you know,
one more question. In fact, this is very interesting, Roshan, what you said, and especially for many of the students as well as some of the professionals may be watching this conversation. It's so important to kind of give respect or listen to the ideas which come up as a part of our informal sessions or as a part of a formal brainstorming sessions, whichever, whether it is in a university or in a professional organization. I think that piece is very, very important. Many times, Roshan, you would have seen it happening when the idea which seemed to be completely impractical, completely out of, nobody gives it a importance, comes up and becomes and takes the lead in terms of becoming the big idea, as people call it. So there is a lesson in definitely in that sense. You know, there's a question, in fact, which has come up I think it is after you showed those particular two TVCs, how can, and this has come up from a student actually, how can we develop our creative thinking ability? Because we're talking of, you know, how you are able to create a connect with the consumers, which is very, very honest, number one, which is based on, and you took Piyush's name as well, which is based on, you know, absolutely simple observations of life around you. And three is that you are able to convert that ideas or observations into some great pieces of work, which you said. So how do we develop our creative thinking ability?
Firstly, don't lose touch with your audience. Very often, हम बॉम्बे और दिल्ली के कुछ कोनों में बैठ के सोचते हैं कि हम हिंदुस्तान को जानते हैं, विच इज रबिश. आपको भारत घूमना पड़ेगा. यू नीड टू ट्रैवल द कंट्री. आई कांट टेल यू, इम्तियाज अली इज अ वेरी गुड फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन, एंड इम्तियाज ऑफन सेज दैट माय बेस्ट आइडियाज केम व्हेन आई वाज ईव्सड्रॉपिंग ऑन पीपल ऑन ट्रेन्स फ्रॉम जमशेदपुर टू दिल्ली. यू नो, अगर आप एक ऐसे इंसान के लिए एड बना रहे हैं जो टीयर थ्री सिटी में रहता है और आप कभी गए भी नहीं है टीयर थ्री सिटी में, आप क्या बनाएंगे? No, so number one, be in touch. Karma, the entire thing that when it was created, it has become a runway success. Why did it become a success? Because when I was talking to the CEO, he's a good friend, and he turned and said, he says, you know, Roshan, I could have looked at data, which said 30% of Indians listen to this, 20% listen to that, 25% listen to this music, and said, हमारे तो पुचारी HMV सारेगामा की सारे गाने जो हैं कोई नहीं सुनता. He said, what I did was that I said, मैं दो तीन शहर जाके ना कंज्यूमर रिसर्च में बैठ के लोगों को सुनूंगा. एंड इन वन ऑफ द रिसर्चेस वन लेडी टर्न्ड एंड सेड कि यार हमको तो ना अपने यूथ में बहुत मजा आता था. हम लोग किचन में बैठ के चार चार घंटे अमीन सैनी साहब को सुनते थे, वो गाने बजाते रहते थे पीछे. And she used this line. She says, ना गाने बदलने की झंझट. You know, उनको पता था हमें क्या पसंद है.
True.
So he came back and said, for a generation of India, which is over the age of 40, the people who were over the age of 40, when they were 15 years old, they were listening to radio. They were not listening to MTV. They were not listening to TV. They were not listening to YouTube. So jab wo 15 saal ki umar mein radio sun rahe the, that means anyone over the age of 40 has actually grown up on nostalgia. Therefore, nostalgia can be made into a product. And therefore, let us make a box that contains nostalgia. Karva is your entry into nostalgia, right? And that's how they created a product that went viral and became so big. Virality कहाँ से आई? क्योंकि आपने honestly consumer को सुना. तो पहली बात, if you want to be creative, is listen to your consumer. Go where your consumer goes. अगर आज आपको TikTok वाले audience को pick up करना है, तो आप TikTok पे जाइए. अगर आप गए नहीं, आप नहीं बना सकते. आपको टकाटक, चिंगारी, मजा सब पे जाना पड़ेगा. मौज, सॉरी, सब पे जाना पड़ेगा. और अगर नहीं गए तो बस डोंट ट्राई इट योरसेल्फ. लीव इट टू द एक्सपर्ट. द प्रॉब्लम हैपेंस व्हेन समबडी एल्स कम्स अप विद अ ग्रेट आइडिया. और हम लोग, यू नो व्हाट वी डू इज, आई मीन, एंड यू नो, एंड समबडी सेड दिस टू मी वेरी ब्यूटीफुली. ही सेज, यू नो, हम चाहते हैं कि शेर को हायर करें. और पहले जब शेर आके धारता है तो कहते हैं, धारता बहुत, उसके दांत काट दो. फिर वो गुस्से में आके पंजा मारता है, पंजा बहुत जोर का मारता है, इसके नेल्स को भी काट दो. तो बचा क्या? शेर थोड़ी ना रह गया. सो यू नो, इट्स सो इंपॉर्टेंट टू लेट दोज क्रिएटिव आर्ग्यूमेंट्स, दोज डिबेट्स हैपन. यू कांट, आई यूज अ लाइन वेरी ऑफन नाउडेज, सेइंग यू कैन नॉट क्रिएट ब्रिलियंस इन अ सी ऑफ सेमनेस.
वाओ, वेरी नाइस.
You must find, you know, I do something. I watched a Marathi play yesterday, by the way, in Dubai. Marathi play. मुझे मराठी नहीं आती. मैं गया, बड़ा मजा आया. दो नई चीजें सीखी, कुछ नया चीज. सो यू नो, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डेवलप योर क्रिएटिव थिंकिंग एबिलिटी, नंबर वन, गो वे योर कंज्यूमर इज. नंबर टू, फीड योर इमेजिनेशन, फीड योर माइंड. आई एम दैट क्यूरियोसिटी दैट मेड मी यूनिक एज अ चाइल्ड इज द क्यूरियोसिटी दैट कीप्स मी इवन एट 50 लाइक अ चाइल्ड. I am so curious. Now I'm trying to learn about crypto and Ethereum and DAO and DeFi and tokens and NFTs because I'm just curious. Yeah. I want to know ये कैसे होता है. You know, मैं हर हफ्ते कोई नया app try कर रहा होता हूँ for some rubbish. I found one app, by the way, that is now supposed to help you in your creative block. It's called Sudowrite. अच्छा, अच्छा, try करते. You know, this, so you must set aside half an hour a day minimum to experiment. Experiment. Just go and experiment without the fear of failure. You will remain creative all your life.
Wow, wonderful. It's a brilliant piece of and extremely you know, interestingly, you gave me those. In fact, Roshan, you know, one of the things which I often, you know, share it with friends or with people or even some of the students that I meet up. You know, when I was growing up, I was in school in Lucknow, and I remember, you know, my uncle used to write. He was an author. He was a writer. You know, Rag Darbari likhi unhone.
Oh, my God.
So, and you know, Roshan, I walked up to him one day, Shilal Shukla, and I said, you know, I also need to become a writer. I think I have imagination. I can write. Just say essay likhna ho. And you know, what he had asked me, I thought that he'll give me some tips of writing and I'll start writing a book. He said, how many times you really go to a village, or how many times you actually, you know, take the lanes in within Lucknow, and how much do you observe? So his whole point and conversation with him was how much I observe, number one, and how much I'm able to observe whatever I'm seeing. And I'm able to relate to things around me as well. So this relatability, observation, what you just said, is amazing. And I think that is where the real, you know, the sparks of creativity or imagination, which is so, so wonderfully you put it. And I remember, you know, somewhere reading some time back where it said that it's an end of imagination for many people. The moment you stop imagining, then you don't have a chance of going forward. So I think very, very nicely put. You know, before you come to commune, Roshan, there was a question which had come up from one of the students again. You know, she says that what is the role authenticity plays in building deeper bonds with consumers and communities? I mean, she's talking in context of the brands, how much the brand should be authentic and how much should they communicate authenticity. And she's asking in context to content creation and expression and advertising or whatever, authenticity.
Yeah, no. So, you know, everything I've talked about, frankly, is about being your authentic self, because there's a thing which I often say, however filtered a life you lead on Instagram, you appreciate the unfiltered truth. हम सबका एक दोस्त होता है जो मुझसे सच बोलता है.
Yeah.
वो हमारा सबसे क्लोज फ्रेंड होता है जो बोलता है कि बॉस दिवाकर no, yeah. enough. Roshan, uh-huh. don't fly so much. You know, you need that friend.
Correct.
So can a brand be that authentic? Some brands can't. See, Pepsi and Coke can't be authentic because at the end of the day, they are selling you a dream. They're selling you pop culture in a bottle. They can't afford to be, though they've tried to be in some cases or whatever. When Pepsi tried to do that that ad with Kylie Jenner of, you know, oh, you know, we are but the protest bhi kar raha ho, Pepsi bhi pee raha ho, whatever. Nahin chala. It got called out. But when Coke went and did the really fun spoken word piece post-pandemic, have a look at that. It right. was authentic because it was relating to what everyone said. Now, here are right. two brands. Pepsi. Coke is not suddenly saying, I will change the world. Coke is saying, I know what you are thinking.
Right.
So authenticity doesn't suddenly mean to be, mere mein na 25% sabun hai aur 20% ye. That authenticity is not there. Mm-hmm. Ultimately, mm-hmm. brands are a lot about feeling, etc., etc. But if you can have a higher purpose, I work, Glitch as an agency, I'm very proud of, because Pooja, who leads it with her entire team and strategy team, is very often able to find very unique insights. So they were working on Vim. अब बताइए विम में आप ऑथेंटिसिटी क्या बात करेंगे. बट व्हाट शी डिड वेरी स्मार्टली वॉज शी सेड इफ हर स्ट्रेटजी टीम सेड इफ विम इज एबल टू वॉश यूटेंसिल्स फास्टर इट अलाउज द पर्सन एट होम अ लिटिल फ्री टाइम टू फॉलो देयर पैशन. नाउ दैट इज अ क्रिएटिव इनसाइट.
सुपर्ब. वंडरफुल.
एंड इसमें कोई झूठ नहीं है. आप ये नहीं बोल रहे हैं विम खरीद लो, विम में ये है, विम में वो है, व्हाटएवर. आप ये कह रहे हैं कि विम क्योंकि अच्छा काम करता है, आपको 30 मिनट और मिल जाते हैं दिन में टू डू थिंग्स दैट यू परस्यू. एंड दैट्स वेयर यू रिक्वायर यूनिक माइंड्स टू थिंक ऑफ ऑथेंटिसिटी इन न्यू वेज. ऑथेंटिसिटी आप अलग अलग तरीकों से कन्वे कर सकते हैं. इरफान खान वॉज अ ऑथेंटिक एक्टर.
राइट राइट.
देयर आर हंड्रेड्स ऑफ अदर एक्टर्स, सब एक्ट कर रहे हैं. यू इवन नो दैट इफ इरफान खान इज एक्टिंग बट ही इज डूइंग इट इन अ फार मोर authentic manner. So to be authentic, be close to your consumer. To be authentic, listen very often. To be authentic, invest in social listening. There's a great brand that I must tell you. So apparently, if I'm not mistaken, I think it was Clearasil. Clearasil tried to do this ad that, you know, these girl puts on this beautiful thing and suddenly all her pimples are gone, and they got panned. They got hammered. The next ad they did was that was they took four scientists, and those four scientists are trying to blow bubbles and do this, that, and the other, and suddenly they end up sitting in a bathtub, and it turns and says, we don't know how to make good ads, but I scientists definitely know how to make good pimple removing cream. Ab wo ad successful ho gaya because you owned the truth.
Yes.
You know, and many brands are very comfortable as to how to own the truth. But owning the truth is very different, right? Look, I Sonu Nigam ke concert mein aake kahun main unse acha gayak hu to log mujh pe gaali denge. Lekin agar main bolu main shaukiya gayak hu par main appreciate Sonu Nigam ko karta hu. So it's just that. I think these are the simple, subtle ways in which authenticity can be imbibed and created around your brand.
And I think it's very nicely. I mean, the examples that you were giving, Roshan, are excellent. Is because the moment you put up a show and you say that there is an ad or there is a, you know, any of the thing that you're doing, David Ogilvy ne kaha tha, and I'll quote him again, that consumers are not morons, right? They are your vibe, so you can't fool them. So I think very nicely said. Roshan, tell us about that commune thing, because when I was trying to understand that, it's very interesting, and you know, some of my students have been part of that, they have been connected with that. So I want to, you know, hear that part of it, and there are a couple of questions which I'll put up later. But please tell us about commune.
So my latest venture and my heart and soul is invested in commune today, because when I made my film Diwakar in 2011, I'll be very honest with you, I was being inauthentic. जब मैं फिल्म बना रहा था, क्योंकि मैं कमर्शियल बॉलीवुड फिल्म बना रहा था, मैं ओरिजिनली एक बहुत ही सुंदर, खूबसूरत, ब्यूटीफुल सी एक कहानी अबाउट स्कूल लाइफ बना रहा था. But I had commercial producers who explained to me the need of commercial storytelling, and I understood it. And therefore, I made some compromises creatively in my script. Now, when I came out of that inauthentic experience, I genuinely felt that I had lost my mandate as a creator. And creators very often go through a crisis of faith. So in 2011, I went through a terrible crisis of faith. And I said, mujhe koi creativity nahi aati, mujhe kuch ideas nahi aate, etc., etc. And I was doing this. And suddenly I had a whole bunch of my creator friends, Ankur Tiwari, Gaurav Kapoor, Mini Mathur, Maria, my wife Shaheen, Vikram Sathe, etc. All of the Nilesh Kulkarni, all of these friends of mine, they sort of created this circle around me which said, it's okay to fail. And I must tell you, see, till that point in time in my life, I had seen success. Now, film comes out, it was okay, it made its money, but it didn't become 7 crore ki film 70 crore ki nahi ban gayi, you know, it didn't suddenly win the box office, blah, blah. It's still, I get so many messages even today saying, sir, such an important part of our growing up, and I love that. And I mean, Ali Fazal was launched through the film, many good things happened. But I just felt incomplete. But everybody around me, these creators, made me feel, it's okay, you tried your best, nahi hua. Now, the second thing that you require as a creator at that point, which I've said to you all earlier, is feed your imagination. Jab aap ek creative endeavor mein you put all your heart and soul, very often you put in your entire mind and everything, and you come out on the other side empty. So how do you fill your creative soul? You fill your creative soul by dating new creativity. So Ankur would take me to concerts of rap and stuff, which I don't understand, but I would go with him. Or Gaurav would come and say, listen, sit with me, let's do this around cricket. And again, I don't understand. Or Vikram Sathe would say, stand-up comedy. Again, I don't understand. But they were new inputs. So Commune started as a platform where creators would help creators fulfill their creative aspiration. And because I was part of a startup fund, I thought that maybe I can bring the same ethos of a startup fund to Commune and fund creative ideas. I realized in 2015 that many people had half-baked creative ideas around new media ke bare mein logon ko itna nahi pata tha. There was one AIB doing well, there was one or two other people doing well, but many people had half baked ideas. And so Commune suddenly said, what are creator ideas that we can either fund or make ourselves? So we said, you know, rather than ignite people's imagination by giving them money and saying come up with an idea, let's inspire and ignite them. So let's come up with great stuff ourselves. And that's where we went into first-person storytelling. I had seen Sarah Kay when she had come to India. Sarah Kay is this young, beautiful poet who's so wonderful in her communication. And I used to follow The Moth in the US. And I came to my team and I said, dekho boss, sasta sundar tikau idea ye. Isme paise zyada nahi lagenge, chalo experiment karke dekhte hain. And the first time Diwakar, we put a microphone in front of people and said, tell us your stories, it seemed that, you know, humne jaise koi flood aa gaya. Like people wanted to talk. I can't even tell you. I am amazed at what people tell us. People tell us about love. People tell us about separation, about money, about loneliness, about, God forbid, you know, sexual assault. People tell us about body shaming. People tell us about, you know, sexuality, gender, you know, body dysmorphia. They tell us, because again, as I say, in a highly filtered life that people today, on Facebook, we show people the life we want to show. On Instagram, we put filters to show people how good we can look. But deep inside, to hum sab ki life thodi si flawed hai. And I call this generation flawsome. They are flawed, but they are awesome. And flawsome is what commune celebrates. We always tell the world that, you know, that we are flawed and we are, it's okay to be flawed. And that opened the floodgates of authentic storytelling, and that built into our biggest festival. Today, Commune is a thriving brand that tells creators, we will help you become your best self. Whether we help you by training you, whether we help you by putting out your content, whether we help you by featuring you at one of our events, that's what we do. I think it's a great segue for me to share one of the what we just, this is the last live event that we had done, which was our Spoken Fest event. And it's something which is very beloved of people. So here it is.
A spot where thoughts find words and words find voices. A spot where poems become revolutions.
Hami pe hamla karke hami ko hamlawar batana sab yaad rakhe.
Sab taaj uchale jayenge.
Where the sparks become fires.
The young who had nothing to lose and everything to lose at the same time stood to face the oppressor.
The bards spin their tales. The spoken cast the spell.
An artist from Mexico City convinced his government to donate the guns to him, and he turned them into musical instruments.
If your heart is broken, make art with the pieces.
Poetry touches the heart and changes the mind.
Where the young become the future, right in front of you.
Aata tu news channel var aalis na, aata tu famous honar.
And chuckles become laughter, with no worries in view. Yes, it's a festival after all.
Thank you for conducting Empathy Bootcamp every year.
Sway, giggle, cry, roar and even scream if need be, but without fear, without doubt.
Stop telling people things like it is not you who is depressed, it is reality which is broken. The next time you're sick, I'll come to your house, throw your medicines out of the window and say it is not you who has malaria. It is mosquitoes who are assholes.
मैंने realize किया कि breakup से लेके आज तक मैं अच्छे से रोया नहीं था. तो मैंने अपने आप को रोका नहीं और एक दो घंटा रोने दिया. जब रोना खत्म हुआ, तो हाथ अपने आप फोन की तरफ गया और Tinder खुल गया.
मोहब्बत जिंदाबाद.
We are the words. We are here. We are with you.
Mohabbat Zindabad.
Wonderful, Roshan. It's so amazing. And you, when you showed us this video, it's so pertinent, because what you were talking, because it just conveys that when commune came up, when you thought about this idea, I'm pretty sure it's totally, you know, you kind of, as if, I mean, I was looking at that video, you kind of touched the chords of the youth and, you know, such a diverse community of people who are sitting there. Something which no format, no television program, nothing, you know, kind of touches them. You can have a rock festival, which is okay. But the fact of the matter is, this is so diverse. So I was looking at those expressions which your photographers have captured. This actually is a manifestation of what you just said.
Closer to 100%. I mean, that's what I keep saying, Divakar, you know, commune and spoken fest, life takes you full circle. And frankly, it is the performer in me giving back to the performers of this generation. It is me paying homage to all the teachers who taught me by providing teachers to them. It is me trying to answer the questions that I had as a young creator, which, you know, I want to answer for every creator. And, you know, I mean, there was a question that I just saw somebody turned and said, you know, this whole thing about, hey, that Brooke Bond video had created a little bit of controversy. Absolutely. Absolutely. Any creative idea, if it wants to stay with you, will provoke you in your mind.
Yeah.
And provocation. Remember, there was a line which said that you know, if your heart is broken, make art with the pieces. There's a line in the spoken thing. And zindagi mein bahut cheeze aayengi mere dost, tumhara dil todne ke liye or whatever, etc. Unse seekhi milti hai. We have unfortunately become a polarized society where frankly ideas such as this, which question your idea of identity, question your idea of Arnab Goswami, by the way, is the guy I taught debating to in college.
Right.
So I am responsible for some of your problems.
Right.
but Arnab, you know, Arnab and I have a deep, I mean, we've always been very fond, always met, I've gone and spoken at Republic, done all of this, etc. And we have our diverse views. We have extremely diverse views. And I remember at an event convention when he had come to speak or whatever, and somebody was talking to him about saying that, you know, you're so polarizing, you're doing this, you're doing that. And he was very clear saying that, listen, this is the flow at the moment. This is what people want. People want me to be judge and jury, etc. And I turned and said, you know, there are so many simple facts that are hidden from us. Jo kisi ko nahi pata hota. The roads that we drive on, the dal that we have, often also comes from Pakistan, by the way, because the tar, etc. पर इसमें क्या आप क्या उस रोड पे जाना बंद कर देंगे, क्या आप वो दाल खाना बंद कर देंगे? नहीं, वी हैव टू लर्न. आई नो दैट एवरी वर्ल्ड गोज थ्रू दिस 30 ईयर साइकिल. बाय द वे, यू कैन सी दिस, इट्स एन अमेजिंग वीडियो व्हिच टॉक्स अबाउट 30 ईयर साइकिल्स वेयर वी गो टुवर्ड्स डिक्टेटरशिप डेमोक्रेसी पोलराइजेशन अमेलगमेशन इट हैपेंस एवरीवेयर, इट हैपेंस ऑल द टाइम. इट्स अ हिस्टोरिक फैक्ट दैट हैपेंस. वी आर गोइंग थ्रू अ साइकिल, वी विल कम बैक टू आवरसेल्व्स, इट्स ओके.
In fact, to that point of Brooke Bond, Roshan, my thought also was that that is a real challenge for creative students, media professionals, anybody who's into artists. Idea is to take a stand. I mean, if you keep on fearing your own thoughts, while you may believe in your heart that, okay, you want to support this idea or actually talk about it, but because there's a fear of voice yourself, you get to know about it and you do not take a point of view, then I think it's not even worth it. So don't even try then. In that case, get into something which does not, you know, push you towards it. So I think, like an idea about Brooke Bond or even Google, the ads which have come in the past.
Absolutely.
One has to take that point of view because, I mean, eventually, if you ask me for many other naysayers, Roshan, this particular Brooke Bond as well, I would really, you know, kind of, I don't think there would be anybody, you know, alive on the earth who would not feel happy about looking at that particular ad eventually at the end of it. So that's the beauty of a great idea and risk taking kai baar. So I think it's wonderful. In fact, there's one question, Roshan, I want to put it again. It has come. It says, is there a difference between creative freedom and creative control? What is the relation between the two, creative freedom and creative control?
Of course. So see, the you are entering an era where everything, the power is slowly coming in the hands of the consumer entirely. And frankly, crypto and Ethereum and all of these things are the next wave where the power of money, which was the biggest power that people used to have, is coming in the hands of the consumer. Very often, most media and everything else has thrived because power has rested in institutions, companies, etc., etc. But see, today at a university, if your teacher is not able to convert, you know, knowledge and experience, आप ये सीख सकते हैं कि 2+2=4. उसका एप्लीकेशन क्या है वो आपको टीचर अच्छा टीचर सिखाता है. इफ अ टीचर कम्स टू इन क्लास एंड सेज 2+2=4, इट्स नॉट, इट्स समबडी, आप वो कंप्यूटर से सीख सकते हैं. बट यू आर लुकिंग फॉर पीपल हु कैन गिव देयर एक्सपीरियंस, उस तजुर्बे को यूज करके वो चीजों बता सकते हैं. सो क्रिएटिव फ्रीडम इज एक्चुअली द लिविंग ब्लड ऑफ योर जनरेशन, आई थिंक, एंड यू आर द वन जनरेशन हु विल हैव इट. हाउ यू यूज इट is going to decide what society we live in. I have a friend called Snigdha Poonam. She's taken out a book called Dreamers. To everybody who's listening, to all of you who are here, Dreamers is a book that talks about Bharat. It talks about a boy in Patna who wants to be a model and is still running fashion shows at the age of 30 because he still believes that he will model ban jayega. It talks of Witty Feed, which is like BuzzFeed, but out of Indore and trying to build their own model. And Witty Feed has changed its entire model. It talks about a man who used to actually collect gobar next to a college where they were teaching English, learned English by hearing them, and then set up his own institute of English. It talks about, a girl who stood for election as the first girl in Allahabad University, saying, why can't a girl be a president? I was supposed to say, I'm a film man. Now, ye aapke generation ki kahaniya hai. This is the creative freedom, and that is why these stories are coming. Creative control, and I mean, when you talked about that, very often you'll have a supervisor, a head, who will try to be establishing creative control. Now, good supervisors will tell you why they want to control.
Yeah.
Right? बैड सुपरवाइजर विल टेल यू ऐसा ही होगा, यू नो, बच्चन साहब इन कभी खुशी कभी गम, कह दिया तो कह दिया, पर वो नहीं होता ना.
Correct.
तो आपका जनरेशन तो कह दिया से इस बात ही नहीं मानता है. क्रिएटिव कंट्रोल, आई गिव एन एग्जांपल. आई रन मेनी कंपनीज वेर आई एम अ मेंटर, एडवाइजर, इन्वेस्टर. आई वेरी ऑफन कम टू देम एंड टेल देम, दिस आर द टू पाथ्स यू कुड टेक. आप ये करोगे तो ये होगा, ये करोगे तो करोगे, डिसीशन आपका है. सो What is creative control? In my case, creative control is मुझे आपके आने वाले रास्ते नजर आ रहे हैं. मैं आपको थोड़ी सी अपनी दूरदृष्टि से यह बता सकता हूं कि यह होगा. चूज करना क्या होगा यह आपका कंट्रोल है, बताना क्या होगा यह मेरा कंट्रोल. That's what I do. That's where I think a good creator relationship happens. Unfortunately, very often in organizations, and I can well understand where this question comes from, somebody will turn and say, no, I'm cutting out this line.
Yeah.
And they will not tell you why. Maybe they're right, but they won't tell you. Somebody will take your ad and throw it and say, this is rubbish. A teacher will tell you your assignment is shit. All this will happen. But this is the battle between very often, you know, authority and experimentation. Very often, this is the battle between somebody who says this is success and you say, no, success is something different. So these are the slightly more philosophic parts of life. Honestly, ye question chalte rahega. Kitna control, kitni freedom, ye hamesha sawal chalta rahega.
Correct, correct. In fact, Roshan, you kind of touched upon it. I was about to ask you in a similar vein. Since you are also, you're also an investor. When I say investor, because you said that you are so curious from childhood. So now, and that's the real, you know, kind of a key to the success that you have seen. But as an investor and somebody who knows creative industry, the processes so well, has done it himself, tomorrow if somebody comes to you, says, I have a great creative idea and I want you to support me, what are you looking for? I mean, if the youth of today, young people come up with creative ideas, and interestingly, Roshan, in the media students that we see who graduate, initially it used to be, you know, placements, internship becomes big. But today I see many of our students just going for a small entrepreneurship, creative entrepreneur. We have courses and subjects being taught. What do you look for in a creative entrepreneur? I mean, so to say.
So I look for two things. In their idea, I look for the following. What's the gap you're trying to address? What's the problem you're trying to solve? How big is the problem you're trying to solve? why are you the right people to solve the problem? इन तीन सवाल के जवाब मुझको दे दो तो मैं इन्वेस्ट कर देता हूं. अगर आपके पास इन सवालों के जवाब नहीं हैं, गलत हैं, व्हाटएवर, देन व्हाट आई ट्राई टू डू इज आई स्पेंड मोर टाइम विद पीपल. सो सी आई एम अ वेरी एम्पैथेटिक पर्सन. आई रिएक्ट अ लॉट टू पीपल, यू नो, एंड आई ऑफन आस्क मायसेल्फ. आई ऑफन हैव फ्रेंड्स हु कॉल एंड से इसमें पैसे लगा देते हैं, दैट गाय हैज गॉट अ ग्रेट आइडिया. आई से यू नो टेल मी, अगर कल इसका आइडिया नहीं वर्क करा, will you still spend time with him?
Right.
Will you be this person's 2 a.m. call?
Right.
Will you be this person's biggest supporter even when he loses interest? And if you, because see this investment, Hindustan mein investment bahut galat nazaron se dekha jata hai. Many people look at investment in India ki maine aap pe paise laga diye, jao, maine tumhe khareed liya. Ye bahut hi ridiculous idea. Internationally, the hypothesis on investment is when you invest in someone, you are client servicing them till they are successful. True. You know, there's this girl I work with called Lee Jin, who's one of the biggest, creative entrepreneurs in the US. She runs a fund called Atelier. And in her first presentation, she says, if you want to be an angel investor, remember, you must be ready to roll up your sleeves and help the person till they are successful. इंडिया में क्या होता है ना, हमारी थोड़ा सा मेंटालिटी है, पैसे लगा दिए तो मैंने आपको खरीद लिया, मैं जमींदार हो गया, यू नो, एंड दैट इज रॉन्ग. दैट मेंटालिटी ऑफ ओनरशिप, इट्स नॉट ओनरशिप, इट्स अ मेंटालिटी ऑफ आई एम इन्वेस्टिंग इन योर सक्सेस बिकॉज माय सक्सेस इज लिंक्ड विद यू. सो आई टेल पीपल दिस, दैट आइदर यू आंसर द फर्स्ट थ्री क्वेश्चंस और द पीपल आर पीपल यू रियली वांट टू स्पेंड टाइम विद. आई हैव इन्वेस्टमेंट्स दैट हैव नॉट वर्क्ड. देयर इज अ गाय आई हैव इन्वेस्टेड इन टू टाइम्स एंड ही हैज फेल्ड बोथ टाइम्स, बट आई लव हिम एज अ पर्सन. I know he will be successful.
Right.
You know, because usne bahut jee jaan lagayi hai, par bada maza aata hai uske sath baat karna, uske creative ideas sunna bahut acha lagta hai. And if you're an old person investing in young people, you also have a, again, I must tell you, I have a slightly vested interest that your young ideas keep me young. So if your idea is old and boring and you come with something that's already happened somewhere else, I'm not interested. Agar 100 jagah ho chuka hai aur phir aap keh rahe ho yahan par because 100 jagah ho gaya hai, I'm not interested. I'm not in it to make money. I've thankfully, with the grace of God, made money. You know, I want to make change. I want to build relationships. I want people to, very often people don't say, ab kya kar rahe ho? I said, you know, every human being at some point is trying to leave a mark in this universe so that they don't disappear, right?
Yes.
You either do it by creating children, or you do it by creating institutions, or you create it by bringing brands or movies that people remember. You know, otherwise, toh hum log jeete hain, mar jaate hain, toh phir kya hota?
Very true.
Sorry, society yeah. philosophic.
No, but Russian, these are, it may appear to be for many people, but I think these are the things for which, this Explore series actually is, you know, how do we get to understand Roshan Abbas as a person from a perspective? Because, I mean, interestingly, you know, whenever I talk to many of people like you who have achieved so many good things, the humility stays. Roshan, I mean, that's amazing. That's amazing. And I think that is something, whether I'm a youngster or I'm an elder, whatever, this humility part of it is so infectious. I mean, you don't lose a sight. You started your conversation today by saying where you come from, what you did, where you failed. This is something which keeps a creative person alive as well, because the moment you become pompous and arrogant, then I think creativity would die. I mean, so
creativity is a very, I often turn to people and say, if creativity is a very tempestuous mistress. आप उसको अगर नखरे दिखाते हो, आपको छोड़ देती है. So you, it's important to remain in this way. You know, it's important to turn and say, I don't know. It's important to go and, to all the young people and anybody else who's listening, there is a book by Julia Cameron called The Artist's Way.
Right.
And it's a beautiful, beautiful book. And I recommend it to everyone because it changed a part of my life. Because Artist's Way, in the entire book, us kitab ka saar is two things, where she says that, go on one creative date a week. Date something, when she says date, not a creative person.
Yeah.
Koi art form ko date karo. Jo kabhi nahi dekha, wo jaake dekho. To aankhe khul jati hai, dimaag khul jata hai. And the second she says is that every day write 3 pages. Now, I'm not able to write 3 pages, but I definitely get to write at least a page or two a day. And it's not great writing. Any writing, if you want to write today, I attended a session, was done. It's okay. Because... मेरे अब्बा जो अभी भी लखनऊ में हैं और 82 साल की उम्र पे अपनी 11वीं किताब लिख रहे हैं, उन्होंने मुझे एक बार बचपन में एक चीज कही थी कि बेटा कार्बोरेटर से पहले कचरा निकलता है. कार्बोरेटर से कचरा निकालते रहो बिकॉज फिर उसके बाद बड़ी अच्छी चीजें निकलती है, बट वो कचरा तो निकालते रहो.
बहुत खूब, बहुत खूब, बहुत बढ़िया. इनफैक्ट यू नो आई वाज यू नो एंड आई जस्ट गो बैक टू दिस कम्यून थिंग, सॉरी रोशन.
Not at all, please.
I mean, it just got stuck in my head is, and I know that at some point of time, because there's such, you know, bright, you know, students within our university as well. I wish there was a, and obviously when the campus opens and students are back to the campus, maybe you look at doing a small session of commune, because Bhopal has some amazing set of artists.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
So that's something which is, just one point I wanted to ask you, Roshan, before, you know, kind of winding up this particular session is, you know, many times when the students come to us, especially in the areas of media, entertainment, journalism, communication, advertising, all this, the media, entire faculty, many times they come and they say that, so we ask them, so what do you want to become? I mean, what is your goal? And in a very, very innocent way, they said, we want to become anchors. We want to become news readers, right? Which is a great thing to have. I mean, the goal to have, perfectly fine. Eventually we end up telling them that news reader, agar aapko sirf banna hai, so you need to be a journalist, you need to understand news well, right? You being such a successful orator, such amazing speaker, and as the world knows about it, what is your advice for anybody who wants to become a news reader, an anchor, you know, whatever we want, a moderator? What is the behind it? Because there's so many people fascinated by this part of it. There is more to it than just becoming an anchor, I think, I'm sure. So what do you advise?
I think the first thing for any anchor is to be a people's person. If you're not a people's person, wo dik jata hai. Aap dekhiye, bahut log hote hain jinko kabhi kabhar unke, because of their relationship with someone, etc., unko ek kursi bitha diya jata hai, but they don't connect. Aapko apni audience, logo se agar aap connect nahi kar sakte, aap anchor nahi ban sakte. Number one. नंबर टू, एंकर का के अल्टीमेटली टूल्स क्या है? उसके टूल्स हैं उसकी लैंग्वेज, उसकी नॉलेज, उसकी बॉडी लैंग्वेज, राइट? तो उसकी लैंग्वेज, उसकी नॉलेज और बॉडी लैंग्वेज, अगर इन तीनों पे आपको कंट्रोल नहीं है तो एंकर मत बनिए. डोंट ट्राई टू बी एन एंकर, बिकॉज यू नो बींग अ वैक्यूअस एंकर, रिमेंबर देयर वाज दिस बिग मीम दैट हैपेंड अबाउट अ गर्ल हु वाज एंकरिंग समथिंग एट अ फिल्म फेस्टिवल एंड you know, she asked the wrong questions and she became a big meme and everybody, first there were people very laughing at her, then people very angry at people who were laughing at her. But the issue was that the poor girl had been thrown into a situation where she had no time for homework. Right. So it's so important that your mind is filled. Remember what I said, feed your imagination. Right. And the third thing is you must have a viewpoint. Bina viewpoint ke, you become a echo. Do you want to be an echo or do you want to be a voice?
Correct.
तो अगर आपको वॉइस होना है ना, तो आपको अपनी अंदर की आवाज को सुनना पड़ेगा. जो मैंने आपसे, जो हम लोग अभी ब्रुक बॉन्ड में डिस्कस कर रहे थे, एक अंदर की आवाज होती है. सही गलत मुझे फर्क नहीं पड़ता, ये मेरी आवाज है, आपको नहीं सुनना मत सुनिए. गो समवेयर एल्स, यू विल फाइंड. आई मीन, वॉट इज फॉक्स न्यूज एंड वॉट इज यू नो CNN, वॉट इज NDTV एंड वॉट इज रिपब्लिक, दे जस्ट टू डिफरेंट व्यू पॉइंट, यू चूज. सो मेक योर choices. थाली का बैंगन मत बन जाइएगा, बिकॉज उसमें ना आपको कोई नहीं रिस्पेक्ट करता. आपको पैसे मिल जाएंगे, आपको शोहरत मिल जाएगी, आपको इज्जत शायद नहीं मिलेगी. यानी इज्जत भी देखिए, एक होती है बिकाऊ इज्जत, इज्जत और एक होती है, that's why I said शोहरत. शोहरत भी you know, लोगों ने आपकी बात कर दी, बिकॉज वन साइड ऑफ पीपल इज्जत. यू नो आई ऑफन टर्न एंड से, एंड दिस इज अ लाइन आई से वेरी ऑफन, बिकॉज आई हैव सो मेनी फ्रेंड्स हू मेड लॉट्स ऑफ मनी एंड दे कीप टॉकिंग अबाउट बिग कार्स एंड बिग हाउसेस एंड बिग दिस एंड बिग दैट. And it takes me back to a statement my parents had made to me in Lucknow, because they are both teachers. And they said, never mistake your self-worth with your net worth.
Wow.
You know, ye ek ad bhi tha, I remember once, for some Jeep or something. But I always remember this, that do not confuse these two things. Aap ameer jo hote hain, apne khayalon mein hote hain, you have a wealth of knowledge, a wealth of friends, wealth. ये पैसे वाली जो वेल्थ होती है ना, ये बहुत ट्रांजिटरी होती है. एंड आई नो आई मेड इट सो आई कैन से इट, इट्स अ लॉट इजियर. बट एज एंकर्स, डोंट डू इट बिकॉज टुमारो यू से यू नो आई विल बी सच अ बिग एंकर दैट आई विल बी ऑन दिस चैनल. डू यू हैव अ वॉइस व्हिच इज टेलिंग यू यू वांट टू स्पीक? डू यू हैव नॉलेज दैट वांट्स टू गेट आउट? आर यू लिसनिंग? एंड टू बी अ ग्रेट एंकर, ऑनेस्टली माई लास्ट पॉइंट इज बी अ ग्रेट लिसनर. अगर आप सुनेंगे नहीं ना, बी इंटरेस्टेड इन अदर्स. डोंट, ये अपना बखान करने वाले बहुत एंकर हैं, पर वो एंकर नहीं है, वो दे आर एम्प्टी वेसल्स, राइट, व्हिच मेक मोस्ट नॉइज. Just remember that. I'm telling you, and it's a truth of life.
This is so good, Roshan. This is really good. I mean, I just wish that this was a physical setting and you were around.
Oh, I hope we can do it soon.
Yes, I just pray and I really hope. It's so good to hear you and listen to you. It's so amazing. And I was just trying to, you know, kind of quickly get, you know, the key takeaways from this session itself. I mean, there's so many that I can't kind of summarize it, but I know that curiosity is a big, big play. I mean, this is what keeps us alive, keeps us going. And most of you who are listening to us would have seen what Roshan said. Be close to the consumer. That's a lesson that you hear in the classes from many teachers, but you heard it from a practitioner, person who has seen it very close and keeps on doing that particular thing. That's why those success is there. Feed your imagination and being imaginative, open to reality, open to possibilities rather, is something. And one of the things which is very endearing to me and what Roshan said, and I think very much you can see the work that he has done it along with his team and people is this higher purpose. There's a, you know, when I heard you, Roshan, throughout the journey, some things which you talked about, this particular undercurrent of it, there's a purpose. There's a larger purpose. You're not getting swayed by the big highs and spikes of success that you get. People look at up to you. There's so much of humility. That's why I brought in this word of humility as well as the purpose part of it. I think the biggest challenge for all of us from any generation, even the youngsters, is to keep the higher purpose in mind, because eventually at the end of it, whichever discipline, whichever career that you pick up, you need to make an impact. Because if you make an impact, as Roshan, you said, you would end up making great money and great glory and whatever is that, and everything would come to you. So I think this is a great piece of advice. You know, this Explore series, Roshan, as we were discussing, you know, it essentially is to stimulate ideas, insights from the best in the business, in terms of, you know, from the industry, from various facets of life. And what, you know, Jagran and Viscraft Mime are trying to do is to bring the academia and the practice of the industry leaders together. You know, discuss many things. You end up fostering talent. You kind of, many things, if somebody heard you very, very closely, would get equipped with some of the things which you talked about. And I'm pretty sure some of the books you talked about, I'm sure that, you know, they would have picked it up. Incidentally, Roshan, we are working very closely with Witty Feeds. So we have a Witty Feeds Center for New Media where, you know, Vinay Singhal and all of us collaborate and do many things. So these are very good examples that you gave. And I think it was an exceptional listening for me. A pleasure for me to be with you in this particular session and converse with you. Thank you so much for doing this. These Explore series, everyone who's out there, is you know, different episodes will be coming up every weekend, done by Jagran and Viscraft, the School of Entertainment and Events. Very many good people would come up. In the past, we had Ashish Kulkarni, Sam Panchmukhi, we had Sanjoy Rai the last week, and we have Roshan today. Amazing set of people, and I think we are all loving it. Me and Sushma both are loving it when we are with them in this particular conversation. Roshan, I'll thank you for taking this time out. You spent some time conversing with us before this particular session to build up this session, and we really look forward to hosting you at the university together with this craft mind, and I'm sure that God would you know, get you to the campus soon. I'm so happy that I learned you from Lucknow, and I think there is a bond now. I just formed it with you in my head. So look forward to catching up with you again soon. Thank you so much for listening in, and you know, do join us again for the next episode. And bye-bye. And thank you so much, Roshan, again.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Divakar, for being such a wonderful host, for giving me the opportunity to speak to everyone. I like to continue these conversations. So to anybody who is there, I am Roshan Abbas on Twitter and Roshan1970 on Instagram. You can just find me and follow or just be a part. And community is, again, on all these platforms. It would be lovely if you become a part of our journey, because we've just launched internationally in UAE. We hope to be a global brand. So we're already in India. We are now in UAE. We'll be in UK next. But I hope you all can be part of this journey. And thank you once again. Thank you, Divakar. Thank you.
Roshan, just one bit before you leave us, because I think I just wanted to have this message going out for Jagran Viscraft Mime School of Entertainment and Events. Anything that you want to say to the school? And I must also thank MESC being our skills, skills partner in this particular Explore series. They have been amazing in terms of supporting us from behind, doing everything for us, getting connected and whole lot of things. So thank you so much, MESC. Roshan, if you can just give a last message to the school.
Sure. I genuinely think that Viscraft Mime is doing something absolutely unique, and to be with Jagran Lake University. The minute I got the message from Sabas and Sushma, I immediately said yes, because spending time with people who are trying to be pioneers in the industry is always something I enjoy. And I wish them all the best. I wish you all the best in your endeavors. Do really, really well. Continue to spread light and knowledge, because that's what the world needs. And for everybody who's out there, learn and then go and put it into practice, because that's what really will change the world and make it a better place. So thank you once again for the opportunity, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Roshan. And bye-bye.